All right, standing out here outside the Mayweather Boxing Club with the very interesting Rocco Santomauro, who is one of the participants here on the second season of the upcoming show Knockout that'll be airing on Nuvo TV. Rocco, first, how did you get involved with this series? First of all, what the hell is that?
This is mate. It's my tea. We drink this in my country.
And that's Uruguay, legal?
Argentina. Yeah. It's just a caffeinated tea. It's all natural. Good for you.
All right. So anyway, how'd you get involved with the show?
My management team hit me up, and the producer / promoter of the show had wanted me to be on the show, and I accepted.
So, what are you hoping to gain out of this show? I mean, I know you're a guy that's, you know, you're 12-0 impressive record, but I know, knowing you a little bit, that, you know, you're kind of not happy as far as you know, the lack of exposure or the opportunities you've had. So what was your thinking behind getting involved with this, and what do you think it will, you know, potentially do for you?
Definitely looking for some more recognition. I feel like I have a lot of potential that people haven't seen yet. Being on the show, allowing a lot of promoters, managers, matchmakers, etc., see me and know who I am, know that I'm the real deal. You know, that's what it's all about. So I definitely want that kind of exposure, so people can know who Rocco is for me. You know.
Hey, what do you think about these trainers they got going? Last year they had Floyd Sr., Yoel Judah, and Ruben Guerrero. This year Floyd Sr.'s back, and joining him will be Robert Garcia and Jack and Shane Mosley. What do you think about a crew like that potentially getting to work with some of those guys?
I think it's unbelievable, man. I think that's fantastic. I mean, the first show had a great cast, but when I found out about these trainers coming out, I mean, you're talking about Robert Garcia, Trainer of the Year, Shane and Jack together, and then who, of course, Floyd Sr., you know, he's a master, he's a guru, he knows what he's doing, you know? So, yeah, I'm really excited about working with them trainers. So. It's a big opportunity, bro.
You got anybody that you're leaning towards that you'd like to get to work with?
You know, it would be great to work with Trainer of the Year Robert Garcia, of course. But it's hard to pick between all of them. You know, Jack and Shane. I mean, who wouldn't want to work with them? And Floyd Sr., you know, the magic man behind Lil Floyd. You know, it's very hard to pick. Hard to pick. You know.
Well, have you got a chance to watch any of the first season? Interesting, you know, especially the dynamics with Floyd and Ruben. I'm not sure that'll happen this year, but did you get a chance to check any of that out? And if so, what'd you think about it?
Yeah, I thought it was great, man. I didn't know much about the show, actually, till it was brought to my attention. And then once I found out about it, I started looking at the episodes the last few days, and I got really excited because it was an entertaining show, especially if you're a boxing fan and you know what's going on in the sport. It was great. It was great.
Now, you're a guy that the folks that do know you, especially locally, you're an interesting character. You've done your share of antics, whether it be weigh-ins in the ring, that kind of thing. You know, you've taken cake onto the scale with you and dances in the ring and that kind of thing. So what, folks that aren't aware of you, what can they expect out of Rocco Santomauro during this show?
Entertainment, explosion, speed, talent. You know, I'm going to try to bring whatever I can to the table. I don't know what they'll allow me to show off on the show, but I'm going to just try to be myself, and hopefully that works out, you know.
And up till now, what do you think it is? I mean, it seems like you got it all. You're a good-looking dude. You got a great record, charisma. So what is it that you think that up till now maybe that hasn't quite given you that extra, you know, exposure?
I've had a lot of time off. You know, I went through some injuries way, way, way back in the past that held me back, and you know, just a lot of up and downs in my personal life. But now that I have my little girl, it's, you know, it's clear what I have to do. I'm more motivated than ever. It's like a rejuvenation having my little girl, and knowing that I have to set a really, really high example and standard for her. That's all that. I mean, she means the world to me, and it just gave me a whole new motivation for boxing. The fact that I have something positive to show her, you know, to set an example for her, that's what it's all about. So I have this sport, and, you know, I got this beautiful little girl that came into my life. So it's time to put the two together and make something happen for her, get her a college fund, you know? Mm-hmm.
Now, anyone that's seen you knows that your workouts are ridiculous. Obviously, you're in incredible shape. Reality shows kind of are a different animal. You know, are you worried about, you know, your training regimen being interrupted for for the purposes of the, you know, TV and that kind of thing, or what are you expecting out of that? Or
I mean, they can't keep me from working out in my hotel room, so I mean, even if I can't work out as hard as I want in the gym or be able to show what I can, I mean, I'm going to get my work in either way, and I'm going to take it to whoever I got to fight on the show. So.
And then I don't think you know who you're competing with, but what are these guys, why is Rocco Santomauro going to go there and win this whole thing?
Because I'm the real deal, man. I work my butt off. I doubt there's very many people that train as hard as me, like any athlete, period. So I believe that hard work pays off, and I've been working hard for a really long time, and this is my time, man. This is it for me.
And then last thing, who pimped out your ride, man?
Who pimped out my ride, man?
Yeah.
Actually, the Wyndham Bus Resort pimped out my ride in a head-on collision. And unfortunately, I had to use that money to provide for my little girl. So It is what it is. The car didn't look so pretty, but my little girl's got clothes on her back.
Well, hopefully the show will do wonders for you, and you'll be upgrading here shortly.
Yeah, man. Hopefully I'll be able to look back and laugh at this thing.
All right, Rocco, I know you're leaving tomorrow, heading out there to Connecticut to film the show. Best of luck to you, and hopefully we'll talk to you when you come back as a winner.
Thank you. I appreciate it, man.
All right, buddy. Take care.